Good afternoon, everyone. How are you all, my dear students? I hope you all are fine and safe at home and enjoying your studies. So, my dear students, from today we are starting revision. Before this, we have completed revision of lesson number 1, 2, and 3 in English. So, from today we will start revision with lesson number 4, The Dolphin and the Shark, Farebook Notes. Okay, so as you all know, before starting revision, I would like to tell you one thought. That is, life is like riding a bicycle. To keep your balance, you must keep moving. Life is like riding a bicycle. To keep your balance, you must keep moving. So, if you want to balance your life, you have to move on. So, first we will start with hard words. Take out your fare book because it's time to check in. If you have missed any word or you have written anything wrong, so this is the time so you can check it. Lesson number 4, The Dolphin and the Shark, hard words. We will start with hard words. Okay. 1. Shark. Shark. I will read each and everything so you can check it properly. Okay. If you have written anything wrong, you can make it correct, and if you have missed anything, you can write it. Number 1, shark. Shark. Simon. Simon. Dolphin. Dolphin. Ocean. Ocean. Beautiful. Beautiful. Dudley. Dudley. Lighthouse. Lighthouse. Murky. Murky. Swam. Swam. Grumpy. Grumpy. Swimming. Swimming. Lazily. Lazily. Favorite. Favorite. Lurking. Lurking. Whistle. Whistle. Giggle, giggle. Managed, managed. Chasing, chasing. Leaped, leaped. Platypus, platypus. Breasted, breasted. Gobbler, gobbler. Hooty, hooty. Snooty, snooty. Crawler, crawler. Shuffling, shuffling. Alligator, alligator. Raggedy, raggedy. Overalls, overalls. Frog, frog. Banjo, banjo. Raccoon, raccoon. Fiddle, fiddle. Strummed, strummed. Wonderful, wonderful. Flabbergasted, flabbergasted. Flippers, flippers. Applauded, applauded. Fins, fins. Musicians, musicians. Separate, separate. Trotted, trotted. Occurred, occurred. Creatures, creatures. Brilliant, brilliant. Different, different. So total 46 hard words are there. After hard words, there is meanings, meanings. So I hope you all have checked out the hard words. Now it's time to check meanings. Okay, let's see. Murky. Dark and dirty. Murky, dark and dirty. Swamp. Soft and wet land. Swamp. Soft and wet land. Grumpy. Unhappy. Grumpy. Unhappy. 4. Duck, billed platypus. Duck billed platypus. A sea creature. Shuffling. Walking slowly and noisily. Number 6. Raggedy. Looking old and dirty. Fiddle. Violin. Number 8. Flabbergasted. Surprised and shocked. Trotted. Walked quickly. Give one word. Number 1. A tower with a flashing light at the top to guide ship. Lighthouse. Number 2. Hiding and waiting to attack. Lurking. Number 3. Someone who complains a lot. Grump. Number 4. A garment with trousers and straps over the shoulders. Overalls. A garment with trousers and straps over the shoulders. Overalls. A musical instrument that looks like a guitar. Banjo. A musical instrument that looks like a guitar. Banjo. Number 6. An animal with a fox-like face. Raccoon. Number 7. Praised by clapping. Applauded. Now, it's time to check, fill in the blanks. Number 1. They were very happy in the cool blue water. Happy. The answer is happy. They were very happy in the cool blue water. The answer is happy. Number 2. Simon's favorite hobby was to attack Dudley and his sister. Hobby is the correct answer. Simon's favorite hobby was to attack Dudley and his sister. Number 3. Frog was playing a banjo. Banjo is the correct answer. Number 4. Raccoon was playing a fiddle. Fiddle is the correct answer. Number 5. The frog went back to the swamp. Swamp is the correct answer. Right. Now, it's time to check. Complete the following. Let's check. Number 1. Simon and Dudley knew each other, but they weren't the best of friends. Simon and Dudley knew each other, but they weren't the best of friends. So, weren't the best of friends is the correct answer. Number two, suddenly they heard something shuffling along the beach. Suddenly they heard something shuffling along the beach. Something shuffling along the beach is the correct answer. Number three, Dudley clapped his flippers and Simon applauded with his fins. Dudley clapped his flippers and Simon applauded with his fins. So here, and Simon applauded with his fins is the answer. Number four, now they all swam together and played together and took care of one another. So here, and took care of one another is the answer. Now, they all swam together and played together and took care of one another. So here, and took care of one another is the correct answer. Number five, the music and dancing lasted all afternoon. The music and dancing lasted all afternoon. Lasted all afternoon is the correct answer. Lasted all afternoon is the answer. Now, it's time to check answer in short. Answer in short. Question 1. Why does the author feel that Simon did not really want to catch Dudley and his sisters? I'm repeating the question. Question 1. Why does the author feel that Simon did not really want to catch Dudley and his sisters? Answer 1. Because if he caught and ate them, because if he caught and ate them, he would not have any fun more. He would not have any fun more. Question 2. What did Simon tell Dudley after the show ended? What did Simon tell Dudley after the show ended? Answer 2. Simon told to Dudley that if three different creatures can be a best friends, then we can also be best friends. Answer 2. Simon told to Dudley that if three different creatures can be our best friends, then we can also be best friends. Now question 3. What was the name of shark? What was the name of shark? Answer 3. The name of the shark was Simon. Name of the shark was Simon. Question 4. What was the name of dolphin? What was the name of dolphin? Answer 4. Name of the dolphin was Dudley. Name of the dolphin was Dudley. Question 5. How many strange creatures were enjoying together? Question 5. How many strange creatures were enjoying together? Answer 5. Three strange creatures were enjoying together. Three strange creatures were enjoying together. Now, It's time to check answer in brief. Answer in brief. So let's check. Question 1. How would Simon attack Dudley and his sisters? How would Simon attack Dudley and his sisters? Answer 1. Simon would dive deep in the water, lurking near the bottom, and when he saw dolphins, he tried to bite their tails. I'm repeating the answer. Answer 1. Simon would dive deep in the water, lurking near the bottom, and when he saw dolphins, he tried to bite their tails. Question 2. Describe the funny sight that Simon and Dudley saw on the beach. What is the question? Question 2. Describe the funny sight that Simon and Dudley saw on the beach. Answer 2. Simon and Dudley saw a great big green alligator, raggedy overalls. He was dancing. Then they saw a frog playing a banjo and a raccoon playing a fiddle. Answer 2. Simon and Dudley saw a great big green alligator, raggedy overalls. He was dancing. Then they saw a frog playing a banjo and a raccoon playing a fiddle. Now, last topic of this lesson, that is make sentence. So let's check it out. Number 1. Grumpy. Simon was grumpy. Simon was grumpy. Number 2. Swamp. The frog went back to the swamp. The frog went back to the swamp. Number 3. Friends. At last, Simon and Dudley become the best friends. At last, Simon and Dudley become the best friends. So, my dear students, this is the fair book notes of lesson number 4, The Dolphin and the Shark. Now, let's move to poem number 5, that is The Plaint of the Camel. The Plaint of the Camel we have already revised. Poem number 5, The Land of Counterpane. The Land of Counterpane. So first we will recite a poem. Okay, let's start. When I was sick and lay a bed, I had two pillows at my head. And all my toys beside me lay. To keep me happy all the day. And sometimes for an hour or so. I watched my leaden soldiers go. With different uniforms and drills. Among the bedclothes through the hills. And sometimes sent my ships in fleets all up and down among the sheets, all up and down among the sheets, or brought my trees and houses out, or brought my trees and houses out, and planted cities all about, and planted cities all about. I was the giant great and still, I was the giant great and still, that sits upon the Pelow Hill, that sits upon the Pelow Hill, and sees before him dale and plain, and sees before him dale and plain, the pleasant land of Counterpane, the pleasant land of Counterpane. Now this is the textual exercise which already I explained you, so today just we will read. Complete these sentences. 1. This poem is about a child who lay in bed as sick, sick. Number 2. The speaker had two pillows at his head. Number 3. The speaker's toys were laid beside him to keep him happy. Keep him happy. Number 4. The speaker watched the soldiers go with different uniforms. Different uniforms. Number 5. The speaker planted cities all about. Cities all about. Now, fair book notes, hard words. Hard words. Number 1. Sick. Sick. Pillow, pillow. Happy, happy. Watched, watched. Leaden, leaden. Soldiers, soldiers. Uniforms, uniforms. Drills, drills. Flits, flits. Brought, brought. Giant, giant. Dell, dell. Pleasant, pleasant. Counterpane, Counterpane. Now it's time to check meanings. Leaden, made of lead. Leaden, made of lead. Drills, military exercises. Drills, military exercises. Bed clothes, sheets and covers. Bed clothes, sheets and covers. Pleasant, happy. Pleasant, happy. Counterpane, bedspread. Counterpane, bedspread. Sick, ill. Sick, ill. Now it's time to check give one word. It's time to check give one word. Group of ships, flit. Group of ships, flit. Number 2. A large flat area of land, plain. A large flat area of land, plain. Now it's time to check rhyming words. It's time to check rhyming words. Lay, day. Lay, day. Drills, hills. Drills, hills. Flits, sheets. Flits, sheets. About, out. About, out. Now it's time to check opposites. It's time to check opposites. Happy, unhappy. Happy, unhappy. Pleasant, unpleasant. Pleasant, unpleasant. Day, night. Day, night. Before, after. Before, after. Now, answer in short. Answer in short. Question 1. What did the speaker do with his ships. What did the speaker do with his ships? Answer 1. The speaker sent his ships in fleets all up and down among the ships. The speaker sent his ships in fleets all up and down among the ships. Now, question 2. How was the speaker able to see the dell and the plain? Question 2. How was the speaker able to see the dell and the plain? Answer 2. The speaker considers himself to be a giant sitting on a pillow hill, so he can see the dell and the plain. I'm repeating answer. The speaker considers himself to be a giant sitting on a pillow hill, so he can see the dell and the plain. Now, question 3. Pick a word from the poem that show that the speaker liked the land that he spoke about. Question 3. Pick a word from the poem that show that the speaker liked the land that he spoke about. Answer 3. The word pleasant shows that the speaker liked the land that he spoke about. The word pleasant shows that the speaker liked the land that he spoke about. Now, answer in brief. Question 1. Why did the speaker refer to himself as a giant? Why did the speaker refer to himself as a giant? Answer 1. The speaker referred to himself as a giant because all his playthings, which he imagines are real ships and soldiers, are much smaller in size than he is. I am repeating the answer. Answer 1. The speaker referred to himself as a giant because all his playthings, which he imagines are real ships and soldiers, are much smaller in size than he is. So now, my dear students, this is the end of the poem 5, Fair Book Notes. So today we revised lesson 4, The Dolphin and the Shark, and poem 5, The Land of Counterpen. So we have completed both the revision. I will send you PDF again. So regarding this, if you are having any doubts, feel free to message me on my WhatsApp number. And if you have missed anything in your fair book, then you can complete it. So we will meet in our next session with the new topic. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.